that, we welcome you to EIF Airbound 2016. As always, your host, EIF owner Carney. And this matchup is our opening match of the evening. It is the first of two semifinal matchups in the 2016 Airbound X Division Tournament. Introducing first on his way to the ring, from Houston, Texas, Tyron Hunt! Well, according to Tyron's character that he's representing, he may be phenomenal, but if you're asking me about his brain, I would say that it is absolutely moronic. But either way, we're here, and so is he in the semifinals of this year's tournament. Tyron Hunt may not have gotten the call to the 2016 BFG tournament, as you all heard on the pre-show, but he does have an opportunity in this X Division tournament. After defeating his first round opponent, Tyron is now in the semifinals and trying to get one step closer to winning a championship. He has not done so in well over 6 months, and Tyron is hoping that drought ends tonight. His opponent's a guy who also can't really say that he's been in a great position with championships. A little starved is DZ, but they both have an appetite for championships, the X Division Championship to be specific. And we're going to see who can emerge between these two and punch their ticket to the finals of the tournament that will take place later on this evening. Introducing his opponent, making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio, DZ! And DZ and Tyron Hunt, we talk about BFG. Oh, DZ just made it into this year's BFG at number 16. These two actually fought in the opening round of last year's Battle for Glory All-Stars tournament. DZ ended up getting beat by Tyron Hunt. It was an ED tournament, so you have to wonder if Lady Luck will be on Tyron's side once more. DZ, of course, punched his ticket, much like Tyron, in a fairly convincing fashion. Both of these guys heading into the X Division tournament weren't really sure what we were going to expect, but Tyron dominated Untamed Legend, and DZ made quick work of Big Steph. One finisher was all it took for DZ to get his win, and now, after the entrances have been made, of course, if you guys are watching, which obviously, how are you not hearing unless you're watching, we do make these matches on Xbox Live. If you're a new viewer, this is Xbox Live Wrestling. These guys are real people competing against each other, and we're inviting them right now as Ratluck will be joining me. Ratluck, our cameraman for tonight. And again, technical difficulties do sometimes occur in our broadcast. One of them already happened. That's why you guys saw we came on a little bit later after that hype video than we would have liked. But hey, guys, you know what? It happens to the best of you, right? And sometimes the worst. That's why Tyron's in here. Just kidding. Tyron Hunt certainly can't say he's the worst right now because he's punched his ticket this far into the semifinals. We want to remind everybody that these tournament matchups, the first round was all normal. Second round is normal, but the finals of this tournament will be taking place again tonight for the X Division Championship. And it will also be an extreme rules match for the X Division Championship in the finals. Our arena for this evening, King of the Ring 96, a little old school, but if you guys saw on that stage, is the cape, the crown, and the throne to declare this year's X Division Tournament champion. And of course, we have so many matches also coming tonight because sometimes you don't need the cape and the crown, you just need the gold. And we have, other than the X Division, both of our main event championships on the line. As far as it goes for the mid card, US and IC taking a rest tonight. Doesn't look like we're going to see either Jumper or the new Intercontinental Champion Deathlock in action, but that's all right. Going to have plenty of other matches to keep you locked and loaded here, including this opener here tonight. And we, you know, we talk about the appetite that these two guys have and what they need, the hunger you need to have for a championship match. And certainly Tyron Hunt and DZ know that while this match isn't a championship match, the winner moves on to the championship round, to the final round. Both these guys need it. I mean, Tyron Hunt and DZ, they've seen their careers kind of go down a little bit. They've both had some highs. I mean, people can remember Tyron Hunt ending Vinny's 2+ month reign as U.S. champion. People remember Tyron beating Tony Soccerboy in a one-on-one ladder match back in 2K14. I mean, Tyron Hunt, really good year that year. And 15 was all right for him, 16 not so much thus far. Tyron Hunt found himself on the outside of the BFG looking in just moments ago when we announced it on the pre-show. DZ, on the other hand, he gets in the Battle for Glory All-Stars tournament yet again. This time as the 16th seed, DZ, the lowest seed he's made it thus far. So while DZ, sure, you want to take some pride. I mean, in my opinion, whether you're 1 or 16 or any number in between there, you should still be happy to say that you made the tournament. That being said, though, for DZ, a veteran in EIF, a former multi-time undisputed champion, you take it with a grain of salt because you realize, yeah, you're in, but you were looked at as the worst among these 16. And you don't want to be looked at as that. And while DZ can't climb the rungs any further in those numbers, regardless of his performance tonight, he can certainly send a message. And he's got to do that because the guy he's going up against is number one, that being Ratluck. Ratluck, the number one overall seed, will enter the ring first. And again, Ratluck and I, just mere spectators here. We're going to allow ourselves to get count out through disqualification. That will allow DZ and Tyron to have the remainder of the ring and camera angle to themselves. Again, this is the 9th annual EIF Airbound pay-per-view event. Referee counting in slow motion, and finally Ratluck sent to the curb. Here comes Booker. Is he going to do it? No, just kidding. Again, match one. I want to remind everybody that the other semifinal matchup is actually a rematch of the X-Men title match we saw take place at Vengeance between Wicked Jr. and Lizman. Those two are scheduled to actually come up immediately following this match. They're going to get those semifinals out right in the beginning here. This is going to be an awesome kickoff. Here we go. Tyron, you ready?
Yeah.
DZ, you ready? Ding, ding, ding. And here we go. And DZ starting it out with a drop kick. And just like that, Airbound 2016 is underway, as are the semifinals in this year's X Division tournament. This year, the first year in EIF history, all 14 tournaments, this being the first tournament that it did not take place from start to finish in just one night. That was to make more sense for all the other stories going on in EIF and, of course, all the other competitors outside of the X Division. Byron Hunt making his way to his feet, and now finally, it looks like he'll be getting his first grapple. Backbreaker connects to DZ. Byron Hunt and DZ, we mentioned, both having pretty one-sided quarterfinal bouts to get to where they are here. So this one could be a little bit back and forth, but right now, as early on, it is all DZ. Byron Hunt, we mentioned, just getting that one grapple. Here's another grapple for DZ. It's an arm breaker delivered, just smacking the arm, left arm of Byron Hunt back onto that canvas. Byron being ducked underneath, and the neckbreaker connects for DZ as well. DZ with the stomp. Both men, of course, going to have those five reversals. And Tyron Hunt was very conservative with those reversals when he went up against Untamed Legend. That kind of helped him out. Ended up really not needing to worry about it too much. It didn't take him too long to put Untamed away. DZ now picking up Tyron Hunt. And neckbreaker. Oh, wait a minute. Tyron Hunt avoided him. Tyron Hunt. Arm drag delivered to DZ. And Tyron's got to start putting some work in. DZ uses a reversal, and DZ now with a signature. So while Tyron definitely wants to get some of that work in, he's going to have to be careful and conservative with his reversals because DZ could look to put Tyron Hunt out of this match very early on. And Tyron with another head scissor locked in on DZ. Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. DZ was able to pop out of that. It's really impressive on DZ's end already as a signature. DZ still in green bar territory right now, and Tyron with two reversals wants to make sure that he doesn't allow that free finisher, because obviously a lot of people know you get that free finisher on someone and there's really no point. DZ with Tyron in yellow, is he going to try and go for it? I don't know if he was going for it or not, but either way, Tyron Hunt took advantage somehow. Maybe a dead controller or something, I don't know. Tyron Hunt, though, certainly isn't going to complain. DZ about to gain his third reversal back, so I don't know that he wants to use it. And an error has occurred while connecting to the server. However, I'm going to stay in this match because unless it kicks me out, I can continue to watch. Tyron Hunt with an STO, and I ask that both the competitors let me know what's going on here in terms of making sure that I'm still in the match. Of course, Ratluck, fortunately, is the actual streamer of this, so you can see all the momentum and everything from that perspective. DZ stomping on top of Tyron Hunt. I should let everybody know I can no longer see the HUD bars or anything. So, Tyron Hunt using a reversal. Take down DZ, and now Tyron rolling DZ over, kick to the lower back, and Tyron's just got to do what he can to come from behind in this match. And he's certainly not out of it. Hasn't even been hit with a finisher yet. DZ using a reversal and a big clothesline over the top rope goes Tyron Hunt. And the referee can begin to start the count. Remember, Tyron can lose this match by count out here, and DZ could go to the finals just like that. Counted two, Tyron back to both feet. And before the count gets to three, Tyron gets in the ring and drop kicked right back down to the canvas. And now DZ showing Tyron a little bit, maybe showing him how it's done. Tyron tried this head scissor on DZ earlier, was able to get out of it. DZ now showing Tyron the proper way of using it. DZ certainly has a reach and height advantage over Tyron. You can see that, pretty indicative of the characters. Of course, Tyron Hunt representing the phenomenal one, AJ Styles. He used this superstar against Untamed Legend and got the win via the Styles Clash. He could not go for the calf crusher. Calf killer is what I'd like to call it, but WWE is PG. Arm drag delivered to Tyron Hunt. A plate of chops as well. Ric Flair may not be known for the exhibition, but we'll give him a good old woo. World's Strongest Slam delivered for DZ. That's right, now he's known for the women's division with Charlotte, of course. Tyron Hunt being brought to both feet once again by DZ. And, you know, Tyron's had some offense here. He might gain it back through that reversal. But, you know, again, most of the match has been spent in control for DZ. I can't say this match has been as one-sided as DZ and Big Steph's quarterfinal matchup, but Tyron Hunt certainly trying to find whatever signs of life he'll get. Shout out to the Bullet Club. Taunt for Tyron. Make it one. Taunts will reset, as will finishers and all other factors following this match. Now DZ with a spear to the ribs. I think we're both headed to the outside now. Over the top rope. Power bombing Tyron out. That blue padding outside again, sort of going retro Night King of the Ring 96 arena. It's a nice one though. I like it. DZ rolling in underneath the bottom rope and he'll regain the ring. Referee to count of three. Tyron Hunt hitting every button that I think he can possibly hit at once on the controller to get to both feet. Referee at the count of four, he'll start slowing down that count. Won't need to worry. Tyron gets in. Clean entry allowed from DZ and another drop kick. Tyron instantly going for that grapple, and DZ just taking advantage. Neckbreaker connects. Neither man has ever made it to the X Division Tournament Finals, although both of these superstars have competed in them. DZ going downstairs on Tyron Hunt. Low blow. And this could be it. DZ could be looking for the end of the match. Finisher. Moonsault connects for DZ. I only know that because he did it to Big Steph to win it. One, two, does he go to the finals? No, not yet. Tyron Hunt gets the shoulder up and lives to fight another day, or at least another minute or two. DZ going to try and end it, though. 1-0 finisher count for DZ, a near three count. And DZ into leverage, but he'll have to break that up. And that was a manual leverage pin, right? So I don't think he knows what to do, DZ. Not sure, really. There might be some confusion there, but either way, it's match continues. DZ picking up Tyron Hunt. Irish whip. Tyron sent off the rope. DZ with a one-armed suplex. Tyron getting caught on that second and looks like even bottom rope. DZ has to be careful here. Doesn't want to get caught for a stalling rule, so he'll cleanly pick up Tyron. A right back kick reversed with an elbow to that leg, inside leg there from Tyron Hunt. And a quick snapping suplex connects for Tyron. Tyron with another knee driven into the skull of DZ. So DZ's finisher very apparent. And unless Tyron pulls something out of his bag of tricks, which he used to do with smeared face Kurt Angle, I should be expecting a Styles Clash, if any, finisher from Tyron. Tyron Hunt. Oh, what's this? DZ doing a little bit of a crab walk. Now spin and he takes Tyron out. And that was the finisher. Make it 2-0. DZ. 1-2. Oh, no. Not yet. Again. Tyron Hunt. 2-7-8. You might as well call it. You have to wonder how much fight is left, though, in Tyron Hunt. You really do. I mean, he's taking the brute of the beating here. I mean, he's definitely gotten some offense, but just how much? DZ with a reversal, kick to the head, and oh! I don't know what DZ was going for, but Tyron beat him to it. A running forearm connecting for Tyron Hunt. Now Tyron's just going to use a taunt. DZ makes movement. That's two taunts for Tyron. Maybe Tyron trying to signal the end. I don't know. Forearm to the face. Headlock. Now kick to the ribs, and it's like a punch right in that armpit area. DZ, and DZ able to use that vertical base drop kick to help prevent the reach of Tyron Hunt, trying to grapple him. And neckbreaker connects for DZ. DZ up 2-0 in the finishers. Of course, there's a 7 finisher mercy rule here in EIF, but Tyron far from that. Tyron just has to remain consistent here. DZ, another neckbreaker. Again, you're watching the opening match here on EIF Airbound, live on Twitch, the EIF Network. Semifinals match, 1 of 2 in the 14th exhibition tournament. Tyron Hunt versus DZ, the winner to play the winner of Lizman and Wicked Jr. in an Extreme Rules match at the finals of the tournament for the exhibition championship. DZ with a single leg lariat connecting. Now a single arm breaker. DZ moveset, one thing I really noticed about DZ, just tries to immobilize the body parts. A lot of times you go for that, the head and torso. DZ's equally went for both the legs and the arms here, really trying to affect every single aspect of Tyron Hunt in this match. It's a smart dissecting process that DZ's done so far to pretty much a T. And he's got that 2-0 finisher lead on Tyron. He's just going to wait a little bit here. Seats Tyron up. That's completely fine. Now DZ bringing him to one knee. DZ, slow, methodical pace now. And running. Oh, no, the drop kick got stopped. The neckbreaker does not. Tyron Hunt with the upper hand. But for how long? Not long at all. DZ with a reversal. And DZ, single leg lariat, misses. Tyron Hunt tries for the grapple. DZ reverses him. These guys, costly reversals. A strong Irish whip sends Tyron to the outside. DZ using, I think, 3 reversals in a short span there, so certainly I would imagine trying to gain some of those reversals back here. Tyron Hunt, you can just tell by the body expression that he is the more fatigued of the two. Tyron crawling away from the ring. He doesn't want to do that. If you're going to lose this match, might as well lose it by pinfall. DZ, clothesline by Tyron Hunt. Tyron Hunt picking up DZ. Now here comes Tyron. Irish whip. DZ strongly sent into that turnbuckle, that bottom left-hand corner. Now Tyron choking the life out of DZ. These two continue to go here, and they'll go as long as somebody does not get pinned. Tyron with his 3rd taunt. 0 taunts used for DZ thus far. Tyron picking up DZ, and DZ with another reversal. DZ with a single leg lariat, it stopped. Tyron Hunt reversed from DZ. Head scissor takedown connects for DZ. DZ could be looking for a finisher here, could be looking to end. He's already got 2 finishers hit on Tyron, maybe make it 3. Yes! Holding 3rd time's the charm. DZ with another finisher center of the ring. Tyron's not going to be able to rely on ropes. He's going to have to kick out again. 1. And he kicked out at 1. Wow. Well, that might have been resiliency there, getting Tyron to power out so quick compared to the first 2 falls. So Tyron could be, that could be a sign, guys. Again, you think he'd kick out at 1. Maybe in real life that's crazy. But here, realistically, probably uses resiliency. So Tyron Hunt, by using that, might be on sort of running out of gas in the tank, if you'll say so. And DZ realizing that now, just picking apart Tyron as much as he can. Stamina becoming a factor for DZ as well. DZ going to back up. Tyron gets to all 4s. DZ will bring him to his feet. Toward the center of the ring. A Hurricane Rana connects. Stomp onto the chest from DZ. He'll seat Tyron up. And you know, we mentioned how Tyron had the bulk of, DZ having the bulk of the offense. And you could, throughout the match, Tyron certainly had some spurts, but you can really see that now over these last couple of minutes. Pretty much from the time DZ Irish whipped Tyron to the outside near our announce tables, and from that moment on, I mean, it's been all DZ. Another neckbreaker connects. Stomp on the ribs. DZ picking up Tyron. Tyron with a reversal. And DZ with one as well. Anything you can do, I can do better. And Taran Hot. Wait a minute. Leverage pin. Taran could win the match. Taran, one, two, and no. Taran Hot. Oh, you don't need to hit a finisher sometimes. He got a sneaky roll up on DZ, and he nearly caught DZ. Sometimes you sleep on your opponent. DZ will use his first manual ring escape. And it looks like he's going to take a breather. Count at one. DZ certainly has some time. And Taran goes to dive on the outside. DZ played possum. Taran thought DZ was going to take his time on the outside, and he got a little too impatient. And you have to be somewhat conservative. Yes, this is the exhibition tournament, so that high flying is certainly appreciated. But, you know, sometimes you can say there's a time and there's a place, right? DZ with a drop kick to Taran Hunt. And another plate of chops across the chest. DZ with the headlock locked in. Quick snapping suplex connects for DZ. Stomp onto the ribs of Taran. Taran yet to hit a finisher. He's had one pinfall attempt. DZ with three. Taran Hunt hit with the world's strongest slam. DZ continues the offense and continues the finisher count. Make it four. DZ with another finisher. Hooks the leg. Taran already used resiliency, two, and DZ is going to the exhibition tournament finals. Taran had a chance. It was a brief one with that leverage pin. He just could not get a roll here. And for that reason, DZ reverses the decision that happened in last year's BFG, where Taran bested him in the preliminaries. Here in the semifinals, DZ outlasts Taran Hunt and now is on his way to the exhibition tournament finals. And it won't take DZ too long to figure out who he will be going up against, because coming up next, it will be Wicked Jr. and Lizman, a rematch from Vengeance. Lizman won in what was the probably match of the night, most people would say. So again, you gotta give credit to Taran though for hanging in as long as he did, and obviously for a competitor like DZ, really anybody at that point, you know, it's obviously concerning. It's a lot of red flags, because you do not want to see a guy stay around that long, and when you leave a guy in the match, desperate things can happen. But I think DZ really knew, once Taran Hunt had applied his resiliency to that third finisher, DZ knew he was on a little bit of life support there for that match. So did everything he could to take advantage. And again, coming up next, X Division champion Lizman versus Wicked Jr. Lizman looking to be the second X Division champion in history to win the tournament starting out as the champion. Essentially, every round is a title defense. And while Wicked would not be credited for winning the championship if he beats Lizman in this round, we can guarantee that there would be a new exhibition champion between either Wicked or DZ. And again, this is Lizman's exhibition tournament debut. Wicked Jr., on the other hand, well, Wicked actually has not. Wicked looking to yet again repeat and to get back in to the exhibition tournament finals. Last year, he lost as a fan favorite to Tripod. Can he change the story in this semifinal bout and move on to the finals against DZ? Again, we now know the winner of this match to face DZ in the X Division Tournament Finals. That'll be coming up later on this evening. And the following contest is our final semifinal matchup in this year's 14th annual X Division Tournament. Introducing first on his way to the ring from Wisconsin, Wicked Jr.
I like Malcolm.
And Wicked, Kid Jr. It was last year at this very pay-per-view event, Airbound, where all of a sudden Wicked began to change the opinions, to change the EIF Universe's thoughts on this superstar. He became a fan favorite, sailing his way into the finals, and in heartbreaking fashion lost the Tripod. This is a new year. Tripod is not in this tournament, and some say a new Wicked Jr., as for the third consecutive pay-per-view, he'll be involved in an exhibition title match with Liz Mann. These two you could practically call rivals, and this is really almost a spoiler in a way to a finals. Easily could have been the finals had these two been in separate brackets, but they matched up against each other. Wicked defeating Narc Relapse to get to this point, Liz Mann defeating Ebams, and that is where we are here at Airbound 2016. And now, introducing his opponent from Kentucky, he is the current reigning EIF X Division Champion, Liz Mann. And Liz Mann, take a look at the gold. That is not the traditional EIF X Division Championship, which is the NXT title just used the default in-game championship. That is Liz Mann's own. He had been talking about it. Customized EIF X Division Championship. Wow. Talk about some bling. And if that doesn't make... And you know what? I almost cautioned Liz Mann for actually using that, because in a way, if you're Wicked Jr., I mean, now you want that championship. That makes you want it that much more. Liz Mann firmly holding it in his right hand, making sure he demonstrates that he is the champion, constantly looking down at it. But you have to think, when he gives that belt over to the referee before the start of this match, how hard it's going to be to keep your eyes off of it and keep your eyes on the task at hand. This isn't even the championship match yet. Liz Mann still has to get past Wicked Jr. He's done it before. It's up to him to do it again. Again, this matchup is considered a non-title matchup, but you have to think. Essentially, it is a title matchup, though. It is a. I don't know what you want to call it, but do the math. Do the basic information here. Liz Mann loses this match, he loses the X Division Championship. Wicked wins this match. Wicked goes on to face DZ and the winner of those two to become the X Division champion. So as Ratluck has backed out of the entrances, we're getting set to head on to Xbox Live where the match actually takes place. Wicked has an opportunity. You think about it. We talked about DZ and Tyron, how they met in last year's Battle for Glory All-Stars tournament. Well, Tyron beat DZ at last year's Battle for Glory, and now DZ sort of returning the favor tonight. So last pay-per-view, Liz Mann defeated Wicked Jr. Can Wicked make sure he turns that decision over tonight? And speaking of Wicked and Liz Mann, much like DZ, the finalist, and of course Ratluck, our viewer, those two also making the X Division tournament, the Battle for Glory All-Stars tournament, rather. So they have another tournament after this. Invites have already been sent out, so we hope that Liz Mann and Wicked will be on their way to this game. And Liz Mann making his debut in the X Division, or the Battle for Glory, getting tongue-tied here, confused, so much tournaments. But again, Liz Mann is going to be debuting in the Battle for Glory, just as he did in this year's X Division tournament. He's coming in at number 11 in the BFG, so pretty good for Liz Mann, actually higher than Wicked Jr. Last year, Wicked was the number 16 seed. He'll be at number 14. Liz Mann coming in at number 11. It'll be Wicked versus Hostile. Liz Mann versus Beatdown in the opening round of the tournament. So those two, they are considered underseeds in that tournament. They're certainly going to have their work cut out for them. Yeah, don't worry about the network errors, guys. They will happen. So I mean, they have been happening lately. So, trying to get these guys in. Actually, I'll go ahead and remake the match. So, again, guys, for those that are viewing, sometimes we do have those issues. And for any, like, network errors and stuff, we're just going to do our best to work through them. And this is pay-per-view time, so unlike regular shows, actually kind of helps us in a way because we have a little bit more time. We can be a little bit more flexible. So if in the unfortunate scenario, say a network error occurred mid-match, we could always try and just to remake it. So. So the match is yet again up. We'll ask the scheduled parties to go ahead and join. Ratluck has already made his way into the match, and now we await the competitors again, Lizman and Wicked Jr. And following this matchup, we are not planning on having the X Division tournament finale take place just yet. I have a couple of other matches here. We've been talking about the X Division so much here in this opening hour, but again, so many other cool things happening tonight, including our main event. It's kind of based off the X Division in that it is a ladder match. So, in the main event of tonight's pay-per-view, the Undisputed Superstardom Championship will hang 20 feet above the ring, and in a five-man ladder match, Prismatic Nebula Tripod. He will be defending his Undisputed Superstardom Championship for very hungry challengers. A couple of them, people who have not won a main event championship yet. So. Wicked and Lizman having a little bit of technical difficulties here and unsure why. Last pay-per-view just 3 weeks ago, they connected just fine, had a fantastic match. So certainly hoping for a repeat performance for that. Wicked yet again back in here. Network errors have been happening to Wicked as he's been getting in. Lizman has not made his way into the match yet. Has not bode well for the X Division champion. Wicked is readied up. Lizman says he is joining, so whether he's attempted in the past or is just now attempting for the first time due to being lazy the previous 10 to 15 minutes, both of which seem believable. Okay. Worked then. All right, so it doesn't matter actually. I just got kicked off the server anyway, so that works. So anyway then, just to let you guys know, just to kind of reconfirm what we're doing here, we're gonna go ahead and remake the game. Looks like Lizman's gonna be crashing his game. And then from there we will go ahead and try to remake this. And when I make it next time, what I'll do is I'll have Lizman try to join first. And then we'll have Wick and Ratlug join to follow up. So again, my apologies to those viewing. Thanks for staying in here for again EIF's 9th annual Airbound. And one of the things we talked about actually while we were off air for a couple of minutes earlier was the Battle for Glory All-Stars tournament top seeds. So if you guys got an opportunity to see the top 8 seeds versus the bottom 8 seeds, for those of you that didn't get an opportunity to share your thoughts, we were talking about this off air in between the pre-show and going on live for our hype video. So while we're kind of killing some time, make sure you guys feel free to voice your opinions here on Twitch. Let us know what you think of the top seeds versus the bottom seeds in terms of which top seed would you guys say has the toughest first round matchup? Feel free to let us know your thoughts. and somebody in this party, please feel free to unmute your mic or unplug your mic or do something that doesn't make me hear myself 10 times louder than the way I'm originally speaking.
Liz, man, the mic.
God, that is killing me. Liz, man, you there? Unplug your mic. Hate when I have to get out of character. No, I didn't make it yet. I'm about to right now. When I make it, I want Liz Man to try and join first. I just think he's the only one that hasn't joined yet, so get him in. So all right, Liz Man, I made the match, man. So go ahead and join first. When Liz Man gets in here, I'll tell Wicked and Ratluck to join. Guys, if worst comes to worst, I could always try and watch this match without Ratluck. In that case, I would have to temporarily get off the stream for a moment. But, you know, we're willing to do whatever it takes to just make sure we get our match going for you guys here. Liz Man, are you trying to join yet? Bam. Greedy. He's not here anymore, but I don't know why all of a sudden you can't connect. And Ratluck's showing on, it seems Ratluck is definitely having a problem with connecting to the WWE servers. So, hey, Liz Man, actually, why don't Liz Man still can't connect. Liz Man, why don't you get on the servers and make the game, and then we'll join through your profile? Nothing. Liz Man, just make it as a four-man elimination or elimination normal tag, and then pick King of the Ring 96 as the arena. And then when it's I just left the game. So. So. Oh, they might stop you from being champion too. Yeah, Liz Man's internet, some of the circuitry was put into the glittery X Division Championship, and that's now costing him.
Sandwich.
All right, so Liz Man, once you have that match made, let us. Okay, cool. All right, guys. Let's all try and join Liz Man's game this time. All right, I actually tried to join and nothing happened. It's just having me sit here. Should I wait or is it not gonna work? Yeah, there definitely are connection issues. There's no doubt about that. So, I'm gonna try and join again and see if it. Oh yeah, it was a really long pause. So sorry guys that they're trying to view again. I mean, we're trying to do everything we can here. So now it's here. I'm gonna crash my game and then try to join again. Liz, is everybody? Oh well, actually, I can keep an eye on it. So Ratluck and Liz Man. Yeah, it looks like Liz and I might end up having connection issues. If that's the case, Rallick might have to be between him and Hybrid. We'll have to have an interim commentator for the Lizman and Wicked match. But that would end up being an interim. If Lizman were to win, he would go on to face DZ, and that would I still have to get back on the game and hope that this works. If I can't connect this time, then you guys can remake it and we'll have somebody else be the commentator. So, and I'll be able to sit back and watch a broadcast.
I can't really talk right now. So
I've never once, I think, had connection issues with Liz, man. And for some reason, it's this. All right, let me go ahead and just try this one more time. Let's see here. All right, guys. So, it is not happening. So, I guess off that note, then we should probably just have Hybrid watch Ratluck. If you would mind, between you and Hybrid, maybe doing the honors. You guys could do some color and play-by-play or whatever you want to do.
Yeah, I really can't talk right now. I'm a little under the weather right now.
Oh, Hybrid's not feeling too good. All right, so Ratluck might have to grab out him. I don't know. Might have to take some commentary over no commentary to our viewers. So Ratluck can make the decision. We don't have COO brutality here, which makes it tough. Because when issues like this happen, you'd love for him to be here. So we'll allow Ratluck to make. All right, guys, so just to give you guys somewhat of a status quo or an update here on what's going on, we are doing the Lizman and Wicked Jr. match because those two can connect to each other, and that's what's important. Unfortunately, right now, for some reason that I don't understand, and I don't understand a lot of things, Lizman and I are unable to connect right now. So in the meantime, we're going to have Lizman and Wicked have their match on air right here on the EIF Network with the commentary services of our cameraman, Ratluck. Please forgive him. He's not the best. He's really not good at a whole lot of stuff, but he's going to try and be good at this, or at least adequate. So And all joking aside, I have full confidence in Ratluck, and I have confidence that this match should be a great one. I'll be watching with all of you viewers here on the network, so stay up to date here, because Wicked and Lizman is coming up next.
All right, testing 1, 2, testing 1, 2. Can I be heard? Testing. Alrighty, everybody, welcome. I am your cameraman and temporary commentator, EIF Ratluck, and
it'll work.
Sorry. Joining us as our kind of rule.
Turn my mic back or my volume back on my computer. I can watch it.
There we go. We are now awaiting Wicked Jr. Wicked Jr., where you at? All right, here we go. After switching the arena to King of the Ring 96, we are about to get ready for your X Division semifinal contest. We'd like to thank you for your patience and for the technical difficulties that arose with this, and I hope you can appreciate the match we're about to watch between Wicked Jr. and Lizman. All right, we are both going to get in the ring and get eliminated before Hybrid will get eliminated first. Due to poor network connection, the voice chat has been... And Hybrid has just been eliminated as Lord Steven Regal. Now it's Sami Zayn's turn. All right, here we go. This matchup is underway. Wicked Jr. going against the current defending X Division champion with a new belt, custom made by Lizman himself. As this match gets underway, we see that Wicked Jr. starts with a little bit of advantage. In this game, whoever gets the opening advantage usually does have quite a... And... Never mind, alright. The game just decided to push out there for a second. Both men at four reversals as Wicked Jr. hits him with a knee facebuster. This matchup is interesting, not for only for the fact that it's a semifinal match in the X Division tournament, but also for the fact that it's the first time in the history of EIF and 2K16 that we have a custom belt, or a champion with a custom belt. Very interesting as Lizman misses a low dropkick, but hits a forearm to the face. Up, ducks. Kicks being ducked and countered as Wicked ends up getting offense at the end of it. With a big kick to the face. 1-1 reversal seems to be even up with Wicked with the advantage. A little bit of lag, but should hopefully clear up here soon. We appreciate you sticking with us even through these connection issues, and Hybrid Maniac is left and will be replaced by an AI. Thankfully, he's watching. And it seems like the match will continue with Wicked hits a running DDT. And a nice kick to the back of Lizman, the X Division champion. Oh, with a nice little punch to the elbow. Oh, but reversed into a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Lizman misses a dropkick as Wicked misses a drop, and Lizman misses a dropkick too. The exhibition competitors are not known for their accuracy, but for their high-risk, high-reward offense. Oh, Lizman whiffs another dropkick and beats a boot to the face from Wicked Jr. A little bit of lag here, but... And Wicked has to be careful. Letting Lizman up, but punches him in the arm. Ooh, a code breaker. As a normal move, not the Chris Jericho finisher, but as a normal move. Oh, and a disrespectful slap to the face from Wicked to Lizman. Some back and forth reversals and some strikes connecting from Lizman to Wicked. Oh, and with a necklock suplex, Lizman gets back into the game with advantage. Oh, a few strikes from Lizman, and a big key lock kick to the back of the head of Wicked Jr. Wicked Jr. won manual ring escape. As it looks like both men are going to get their second reversals back. A green bar from Wicked Jr. to Lizman, and he doesn't give clean ring in. Which you wouldn't want to do in a big time matchup like this. Ooh, a reversal from Wicked into another codebreaker. He stomps. And he looks like he's going to run off the ropes, but stops, decides last minute. This matchup has a potential for Wicked to green bar Lizman, but it's very unlikely here at this point. And he won't. Oh, and a nice leg trap suplex from Lizman to Wicked Jr. Both men have finishers and two reversals, with Wisman standing tall. Oh, a nice enziguri to the back of the head. Oh, into a curb stomp finisher. Wisman and him, 1-0. Oh, and Wicked kicks out just at 2. A 1-0 finisher count for Wisman. And it looks like a suplex reversal, which will actually give Wisman a little bit of a reversal advantage. And he now has a signature, which he just reversed from Wicked Jr. too. A nice X Factor or Bella Buster, whichever way you'd like to do it. It's a face buster. Oh, no reversals, and he's wake up taunting him. Oh, and Wisman steals the finisher of Wicked Jr. 2-0 finisher count. Will this be it? And no, he kicks out at 2.5. Wicked trailing behind here, who was originally looking to green bar Wisman, but is now tables have turned, so to say. And the X Division champion with a nice slap to the face, in honor of Stardust. Up, oh, Wisman helps up Wicked Jr. and starts to throw a few punches at him before doing a nice side slam to get himself a signature. Wicked Jr. having a finisher, but only one reversal. And a reverse ground grapple gets Wisman back up and Wicked on the floor. The kick-slap variant of that move we saw earlier, as I looked at the chat of the Twitch stream, was actually from Stardust, unless I am mistaken. If I am, let me know, Aaron. And a nice, the first manual ring escape from Wisman. Oh, and he gets clean ring in and suffers from it with a nice enziguri from Wisman. Into a second, a third finisher. Another curb stomp. Oh, and he kicks out at 2. Wicked Jr. gets sat up by Wisman. Not looking good for the shoutouts to CM Punk with a welcome to Chicago. Explicitive can't stay on the screen. The X Division champion here coming back and possibly going to yellow bar Wicked Jr. Up a nice arm bar. He'll have to let go. Oh, a nice chain grapple reversal. We never really see those anymore in this game. For the fact of being so not worth reversing, and usually a little bit harder to reverse as well. And smart Wicked Jr., out of having no finishers and no reversals, gets ducked out the ring. But he does have to be wary of the ring out count. And the lag. Is Wisman going to give him clean ring in? Wicked Jr. doesn't think so. and Wicked Jr. crossbodies the ref and gets hit with a jumping DDT finisher. 4-0 finisher count. But the ref is down. One, two, and Wicked kicks out at two. Which might have well been 5, 6, 7, or 8 if not for the ref being knocked out. And now, X Division champion Lizman working over the leg of Wicked Jr. Wicked Jr. now getting some elbow smashes to get back into this. And a laggy missed kick that Lizman doesn't take advantage of. Oh, Wicked got Lizman staggered. Oh, but he reverses the big kick into a nice scoop slam. Lizman kind of walking around, kind of eyeing Wicked Jr. Waiting for him to start crawling, which he'd have to do in order to do a move, as per EIF rules. Lizman with 3, almost 4 reversals and a signature up against Wicked Jr. with a signature and 1 reversal. And a Bella Buster takes Wicked Jr. down. And sets him up for a nice cross-legged suplex. Wicked Jr. is going to have to find something sneaky or find some sort of strategy to do to kick out of finisher number 5. And Wicked loses. 5-0 finisher count. The X Division champion, Lizman, continues on to the finals of the X Division tournament. After a good dominating performance, will Lizman win later on in the evening? We'll find out as we go over and go back to EIF owner Carney for a commentary for the next match.